scarring after my eyelid surgery. I had upper and lower eyelid surgery 9 weeks ago, and I can see a scar forming in both the upper eyelid area close to the tear duct towards the lower eyelids. My surgeon told me this does not happen usually. He injected me with diluted cortisone 3 times already, but I see no difference. Please help me. I am very scared. I'm not happy with the results. Is this normal? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question with a photo where you have shown what appears to be the appearance of webs that have resulted after eyelid surgery from the end of the incision, the inner aspect of the upper eyelids, creating a web. And what you described is that your surgeon is treating this with a cortisone injection. So naturally you're concerned. And I'll give you a little bit of perspective on what the situation probably is just from the photos alone. Of course, this is in the absence of a physical examination. Well, this type of fold or web can happen in a couple of different case scenarios. And probably one of the most common scenarios is when the skin in the inner aspect below the medial part or the inner aspect of the incision is relatively loose. So when the upper eyelid surgery was done, a certain amount of skin was removed and it was closed where it should be, but because of some of the dynamics of tension, sometimes a fold can occur which tenses up the skin. Another scenario could be that this area is a transition point between eyelid skin and nasal skin, and such that sometimes the incision can heal a little aggressively and become thickened. So, and then other scenarios are such where the incision line in the location can play a role in the way the skin heals. So typically this type of web development of the in the inner aspect of the eyelid is generally managed conservatively. And by conservatively, it is typically through just massage and through, like your surgeon is doing, some type of steroid or anti-scarring injection. Now, this does require some time and observation. Generally, when I see patients who have this, and I would wait until a certain amount of healing has occurred to ensure that the most active part of healing, where, you know, in the beginning of the wound healing cycle, if you will, the initial healing process, the collagen remodeling is such that things tend to get a little tight and there's a lot of extra collagen until there is a softening or a change, a remodeling of the collagen. So usually that's several months after surgery. If I were to approach someone like yourself, if you were to come into my office having this history, having had surgery done elsewhere, and then having this issue, I would probably wait around 6 months before pursuing a different procedure in order to try to flatten those out. Now, just for your edification, the procedure that is done when there is a web is something called a Z-plasty. Now, a Z-plasty is taking advantage of certain geometric rules, such that when the skin has a relative shortage along one dimension, that we can actually move skin in a way that elongates or gives an absolute amount of more skin to compensate for the tension. Now, that is looking further into the future. But as far as your question is concerned about how things are being managed, certainly your surgeon is doing what I think most cosmetic surgeons would do in a similar situation. So I think that at this point you should continue communicating with your doctor, continue complying with the follow-up care. If you're not doing massage, discuss with your doctor whether massage will be helpful. And then if this persists, then a surgical procedure may be necessary, such as what's called a Z-plasty. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.